I want to tell you a little bit about what's been going on at Hope for Youth. For those of you who don't know, Hope for Youth is in Anoka. We're located in the old milk factory across from the light rail depot in Anoka. And where we came from is on March 4th, we opened a drop-in center. But prior to that, for about 3 or 4 months, a group of people had gotten together to try to figure out how to solve and serve the youth that are struggling with homelessness in Anoka County. And there's a few people that have been really key in making that happen. Oh, do we have another one? Tanya Sherping. Is Tanya here? She left? Maybe we can draw another one. I want to introduce you to Carrie Shaw. Hope for Youth is Carrie's vision. She has been relentlessly working with youth through the school district. She's the school district's homeless liaison, and she is a miracle worker. She's been amazing at how much time and effort and love she's put into helping youth out, and she's changed so many lives. And through the time that she's been working on changing lives for the youth and the number of hours she puts in the back of her mind, she's been dreaming about Hope for Youth for how many years?
Many
years. Many more than she'll admit.
Exactly.
And so when we approached Carrie and we asked, you know, what needs to happen? What do you need to help with this problem? She had a crystal clear vision that everybody could get behind, and a group of people rapidly came in place, and since that day, it has been an unbelievable whirlwind of activity that has made this organization just incredible. And and so what we've seen in the past several months is over 250 volunteers come together to work aggressively at trying to solve this problem. We have 3,800 square feet in our drop-in center in Anoka. And in the drop-in center, we're serving hot meals every day. We've got showers available where kids are coming in for laundry. We've got storage for use belongings so they don't have to carry them around with them. We've got a food shelf. We've got two rooms now full of clothing that kids can come in. We're getting anywhere from 12 to 20 youth a day. And right now we have, on Carrie's list, what's the number now?
696
youth that are struggling with homelessness in Anoka County.
I've done a good job identifying. Thank you.
Yeah. 696 youth that are struggling with homelessness. So I want you to understand a couple things about these youth. Most of them are still with their families, but there's still a large number that are unaccompanied. The unaccompanied youth are obviously struggling more, and there's a smaller number that actually don't have any shelter whatsoever. And so we're working on how do we help those kids. And the really tough things to hear are some of the statistics about what happens when you're struggling with homelessness. And one of the things that Carrie's told us is that statistics say that within 36 hours of experiencing homelessness, a youth will be approached and sexually exploited. Too many of these youth decide that that's the best option for them to be able to provide shelter for themselves. And they make decisions that really aren't healthy long term, but it allows them to survive. And they make survival decisions. And so what you're doing here today, what all of you are here to do, and the donations that you've made, and the tickets that you've bought, and the silent auction items, what those things are is you making a difference for these youth. You guys today are changing the world for youth in Anoka. And so I want to thank you for that.
So I just want
want to say thank you, because you know if I start talking from the heart that there will be tears and sniffling, and I know you guys are watching the clock, you know, the silent auction is closing, hurry up and talk. And there are some amazing people that are going to get up and share some stuff with you, so I just want to thank each and every one of you. Looking around this room makes me very emotional, and it's awesome. I see friends, I see family, I see youth. That have blessed me with their presence and have crossed my path. And I want to thank each and every one of you for coming. And I'm going to stop because I feel the tears coming. So I'm going to stop and I just want to say thank you all for coming. Thank you to all of our volunteers.
We have two individuals that would like to come up and speak from their heart. Trinity is one of our board members, and you'll be interested in her story. I'll just leave it at that.
Thank you, Brian. All right, well, I'm Trinity, Trinity Fletcher. So I'm going to be sharing this story with you guys. Bear with me. All right, being homeless was the worst at its best, so we tried it to be that way. Being homeless takes a toll on your emotional and psychological well-being. You start to think, why me, why here and now? But fortunate for me, I try turning negatives into positives. When we would live in our tent in the woods behind a friend's house, it was hard, harsh weather, snow sucked, as well as rainstorms. I was homeless for 2 years, with no family, no friends. I had nothing, thank you. I had nothing, nowhere to go, a high school dropout. Only the clothes on my back and in the bags, until I found Carrie Shop, the angel who has been there for me for many years now. She helped me get back into school and find a place to live. She also introduced me to the board members of Hope for Youth that saved my life. My emotional health skyrocketed with all the confidence that I needed to become a survivor. One thing I remember the most about being homeless was sleeping in my tent and being so scared of hearing all the different animal sounds and not wanting to go out to the potty alone. The worst thing I remember about being homeless was my thoughts going through my head, like all my worries and where my next break would be. Then we found my break, and that was Hope for Youth. Hope for Youth gave me the confidence to find my biological dad, which I have never met before. Sorry. On Sunday of open house at Hope for Youth, and here he sits today. And I thank you, Papa. Hope for Youth is a nonprofit organization working towards fighting youth homelessness in Anoka County. Hope for Youth strives for helping with housing, outreach, prevention, and education. And all the advice I would give to you today, all you visitors, is youth are survivors and live a tough life. So come visit our drop-in site and volunteer some time with our youth. And for and for all you homeless youth out there, keep your heads high and never give up hope. And never be scared to ask for help, because we Hope for Youth are here for you. Okay. A special thank you to my fiance Jesse, who went through all of this by my side. I couldn't have done it without you. I love you.
Hello everyone, my name's Robert, and I guess I'm gonna tell you a little bit about myself, my story, how I came to find Hope for Youth and what they've done for me. So I guess I can start out, you know, where my story of homelessness started. I guess I've pretty much been on my own since I was 16 years old. My mom, you know, did what she could to take care of me, but guess it wasn't enough, so I had to go out on my own, find my own way, and in the midst of being homeless, I would have couches to sleep on, friends' houses to go to, but it wasn't all the time. I spent a lot of time sleeping on the ground in parks, sleeping on park benches, dark alleyways, you name it. I'm not proud of the things I did while I was homeless. You know, I was dirty, I was a bum, I would panhandle, I would steal, all kinds of things that I don't want to ever go back to. So it went on for, 6 years. Just back and forth, you know, having a place to stay for a little while and not having a place to stay. Never, nothing steady, you know, no jobs. Like I said, I did a lot of things I wasn't proud of. This past summer, or I guess I should say this past winter, I decided to make a change. You know, I wanted to turn my life around. I didn't want to be the drifter anymore. Some of it was by choice, I guess, but most of it was just the hand I was dealt, I guess. But I wanted to make a change, you know, and I knew I couldn't do it alone. So I had reached out for help to my friend PJ over there. It was him and his girlfriend helped me find this place, Hope for Youth. And when I first found Hope for Youth, I just thought it was gonna be a cool place for youth to go hang out. And I heard that you could do your laundry there, and they got free food. So I was like, cool, let's go check it out. And it went way beyond my expectations. It was within 2 weeks' time, you know, I had gotten my own apartment and a whole bunch of furniture and kitchen supplies, a bunch of food. And the people at the Hope for Youth, the volunteers, they just, the hands-on way that they handle this, they want what's best for the youth. It's not like other places that I've gone to where they're just, you know, in it for the tax write-off or something like that. I've seen so many places that, you know, are like that. The people that spend their time at the centers, you know, they really wouldn't have their heart in it. But I found that at Hope for Youth. The people at Hope for Youth actually have their heart in it. And that's why I was able to end up where I am today. I got my own place. I got food in my refrigerator. I'm not stealing from people to get by anymore. It's amazing. And now that I have my own apartment, I have time to spend away from Hope for Youth. So my friends will go there, and then they'll come see me. Everybody was at Hope for Youth, and they were asking about you. I don't understand why you guys like me so much. But it's, I guess I really don't know what to say, except for these people saved my life. I'd still be homeless on the streets, you know, begging for change, stealing out of cars. But not anymore. I don't ever see myself going back. As a matter of fact, by next year, I hope to be one of the volunteers helping out the rest of the youth coming in. That's really all I have to say. I just thank you, everybody, for coming out tonight. And, you know, I love seeing all the Hope for Youth t-shirts. Right when I got here, I thought we were starting a militia or something. But I'm going to get out of here, probably giving you guys a headache.
Good kid there. This is what we're here for. We have 696 some kind of homeless. We got 140 that are unaccompanied homeless. And we got about 45 right now that are sleeping in tents, sleeping in porta potties. This is just Anoka County. Give your hearts, open your hearts up to these children. This is what we're here for. 100%, I repeat, 100% of all money raised tonight is going back to these children. Okay? Whether it's bus passes, food, clothing, what else?
Gas cards.
Shelter. This is what we're here for tonight. Thank you for coming. Open your hearts up. Go get those raffles and auctions. Get them up. Thank you.